At you for my car today, right outside the gym. This is what I look like after I get done with the gym. It's not pretty, but I had just some motivation today, some inspiration that I wanted to share. I got asked a lot this week, Sam, how do you stay motivated? How do I stay in that motivated state? How do I keep going even though I don't want to? And to be honest, you can't. You can't stay motivated. It's impossible. Okay, it is absolutely impossible to stay motivated because motivation is emotionally based, and your emotions are going to change on a day-to-day basis. You never know how you're going to feel when you wake up in the morning. Today, I felt puffy and kind of crappy from bad choices, food choices I made this weekend, alcohol choices I made this weekend. Didn't feel too great, and I had to ask my wife for motivation. Like, I had to text her in the middle of the gym and say, babe, I feel puffy, super demotivated, just don't want to do this. And she was like, look, it's a new day. I know how you feel. I know why you feel the way you feel. It's a new day. You got this, right? And so that motivated me. So sometimes you got to ask the people in your life that you know you for motivation, right? Like, you got to ask those things. Like, nobody's just going to give it to you to give it to you without you asking. So ask people to help motivate you. Like, reach out. I do it all the time. I reach out to all sorts of people. Hell, sometimes I fish for compliments just to help motivate me. So it's impossible to stay motivated. But as you can hear from my story, even though I wasn't motivated, I was in the gym, right? Because at some point in time, motivation's gonna wear off and you're stuck with one of two options is to let your life be ruled by fickle emotions, which the Bible says not to do because the heart is deceitful above all things. Don't let your emotions rule your mind, right? Or you can have self-discipline and willpower. Willpower is actually the strongest thing in the universe. It's the one thing that God promises he will not change is your own free will. You have a choice. You have an option to do whatever you want to in this life. And it is the strongest force in the universe, right? And so if you put your willpower into doing the thing that you thought you need motivation to go do, then you don't need the motivation. Action comes before motivation, right? When that motivation wears off, you're either left with willpower or couch power. Like, it's up to you. You are the only one that can make the decision. Are you more dedicated to the person that you want to be or the person that you are, right? Like, are you the person that just wants to stay comfortable for the rest of their life, die and never live their true purpose, like die way before they die? Or are you the type of person that says, hey, this is who I'm supposed to be. This is where I'm supposed to be. This is how I'm going to get there. And whether I'm motivated or I feel like crap or, you know, everybody's telling me I can't do it, or whatever, like, I've made that decision, and I know beyond a shadow of a doubt, my willpower, my decision-making ability is stronger than anybody else's ability to crush me, stronger than my own emotions, stronger than all the things that I hear and all the self-doubt that I have. I know I'm gonna do this. And so my phone just rang. That was kind of weird. I know I'm gonna do this. So yeah, like, no, you can't stay motivated every day. It's impossible. I don't stay motivated every day. But you know what? I know exactly who I want to be and where I want to be and how to get there. And honestly, I'm not willing to roll over and die at 33 years old just to wait around and physically die when I'm 80-something years old. So I'm going to live every day like I'm chasing my goal, harder than anybody's ever chased it before in their life. And that's just my decision. So what's yours? Adios.